Nikobob had been very active and skillful in directing all this work, and he had also built a pretty cottage for himself, not far from the king's palace, and there Inga found Zella, who was living very happy and contented in her new home. Not only had Nikobob accomplished all this in a comparatively brief space of time, but he had started the pearl fisheries again, and when King Kitticut returned to Pingaree, he found a quantity of fine pearls already in the royal treasury. So pleased was Kitticut with the good judgment, industry, and honesty of the former charcoal burner of Regos that he made Nikobob his Lord High Chamberlain and put him in charge of the pearl fisheries and all the business matters of the island kingdom. They all settled down very comfortably in the new palace, and the queen gathered her maids about her once more and set them to work embroidering new draperies for the royal throne. Inga placed the three magic pearls in their silken bags and again deposited them in the secret cavity under the tiled flooring of the banquet hall, where they could be quickly secured if danger ever threatened the now prosperous island. King Rinkitink occupied a royal guest chamber built especially for his use, and seemed in no hurry to leave his friends in Pingaree. The fat little king had to walk wherever he went, and so missed Bilbil more and more, but he seldom walked far, and he was so fond of Prince Bobo that he never regretted Bilbil's disenchantment. Indeed, the jolly monarch was welcome to remain forever in Pingaree if he wished to, for his merry disposition set smiles on the faces of all his friends, and made everyone near him as jolly as he was himself.